Recording is taking time to start. Yes, join your hands and start chanting of Omkar thrice. Oh. Sairam children, and good afternoon to all of you. As all of you know that we are discussing first chapter, crop production and management. We already discussed about the crops, types of crops, that is based on the seasons. Then number of agriculture practices. As you know that preparation of soil is one of the important agriculture practice. Then second, sowing the seeds, then what is third, adding manure and fertilizers. All of you are very much aware about the manure. Manure and fertilizers, these two are actually number of mineral elements are okay.
Sir, your voice is breaking.
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay, sir. Okay. It might be due to network condition. Now is okay?
Yes, sir.
My camera is off. Okay. And fertilizers.
Actually, sir, not clear.
So please be patient, maybe due to network problem.
Sir, the voice is still not clear.
Okay, maybe due to network problem. Vyom, my voice is clear better?
Sir, sometimes it is clear and sometimes it is breaking.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes and no.
Okay, so it may be due to network problem. So manure, actually soil need some elements for the growth of plants. And all of you know that plants get essential nutrients from the soil through their roots, and repetition of crop in the same field, and due to repetition of crops, lot of precious mineral element, organic element and other elements, soil loss. So this kind of repeated crops on the same field makes the soil poor in certain nutrients. Is it clear? सबसे पहली बात तो यह है कि लगातार एक ही जैसी क्रॉप या लगातार क्रॉप्स एक ही फील्ड पर उगाने से उस फील्ड में कुछ न्यूट्रिएंट्स की कमी आ जाती है. दिस इज कॉल्ड द डेफिशिएंसी. एंड योगिता, यू कैन टॉक टू ईदर लेटर. राइट नाउ डोंट राइट एनीथिंग इन द चैट बॉक्स. भार्गवी इज वन more new student. I would like to ask both the new students, please open your camera. Bhargavi and Ira. Yes, she is Bhargavi Kanungo. How are you, Bhargavi?
Sir, I am fine.
Okay, so this is your first class in class 8th?
Yes, sir, it is first class of science, but yes.
You already attended earlier classes?
Okay. Yes, sir.
So Ira and Bhargavi, both of you, welcome in our class, in our school. And this is science class. Weekly two times we will discuss about the science, and I am Devesh sir. Okay, I will teach you science. And this class, if you have any doubt regarding the whatever we discussed in the previous week, because from 5th of April, we started our regular classes. You already got your class timetable? You received
yes,
it?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. Okay. So this is common instruction to all of all the children ki don't worry about the pandemic but focus on your study. And second thing, make your notebooks, write the notes. I will give you extra questions and works after completion of this chapter, or in between I can give you. Okay, and any doubt, anytime you can send your doubt to my personal WhatsApp number regarding the subject. So adding manure and fertilizers, this is third and very important step of agriculture practices. The deficiency of plant nutrients and organic matter in the soil is made up of by adding manures and fertilizers to the soil. The meaning to say that manure and fertilizers ko soil mein add karne se us soil ki deficiency khatam hoti hai. So this is very important step to maintain the fertility, to maintain the quantity or percentage of nutrients, minerals in the soil. Let us discuss about the manure. Actually, manure is a natural fertilizer. Every day, you know that in your kitchen, your mother prepare food, and while peeling and cutting the vegetables, lots of organic waste we generate in the kitchen. And generally, what we did, what we generally do, we throw it in the dustbin and is later. But if we put all these kitchen waste in a day and put the soil over it, sprinkle water, so after some time, what we will see is this kitchen waste slowly convert into the manure. And that's why we call our garden kitchen garden. That is its fertility, its nutrients percentage, that soil of kitchen garden can be maintained the kitchen waste, not the plastic waste. Okay, brother? So manure means natural fertilizers. All of you know that NFL is one of the factory near our area, and that is what is what they produce. They produce fertilizers, chemical fertilizers. You know? So a manure is a natural substance that obtained by the decomposition of animal waste, human waste, and plant waste. Which so these three things: animal waste, plant waste, and leftover the things of the plant's residue. So by the decomposition of these natural things, do you know about the process of decomposition? Can anybody tell me about the decomposition? Catherine, what is decomposition?
Sir, it is the
oh, left. Anybody, Amay, what is decomposition?
Decomposition means
can I? Sir. One minute. Amay is giving answer, then I will ask.
Yes, sir. Sir, decomposition means the
Amay, can you?
Sir, can I tell now? There was a network issue.
Yes, Catherine.
Yes, sir. Sir, decomposition is a process in which dead or organic substances are broken into simpler substances in the soil.
By the action of certain bacteria.
Yes, sir.
Okay. They slowly convert into manure. So, in order to prepare manure, farmers dump all such kind of waste in place at open place and are to decompose slowly. Actually, decomposition, this is a process which is carried out by the microorganisms. And this plants and animal waste can be used as a manure. It is very important. And very important point regarding the manure is that manure provides a lot of organic matter to the soil. Organic matter means humus to the soil. And humus improves the water and physical and chemical properties of the soil. What is humus?
Okay.
Adit, what is humus? Yes.
The sir, can I?
Yes.
The dead rotting organic matter.
Okay. Vyom, what is humus?
Humus is the topmost layer of the soil, which consists of organic matter.
That is correct.
So okay. May I correct?
So is it clear? Okay. Yes, Adit.
So humus is the topmost layer of soil, which contains dead and decaying matter.
Okay. Okay. All of you are correct. So this natural fertilizers or manure provides a lot of humus to the soil, and once lot of humus provide to the soil, it improves its physical and chemical properties. And once physical and chemical properties improve, it gives a lot of yield of the product. It means for the better production from the seed, from the crop, from the field. So we have to provide natural manure to the soil. Okay, I am coming to the point, that is the chemical fertilizers. Chemical fertilizer, it means a salt, is a kind of salt or organic compound that containing necessary plant nutrients. Anybody of you can tell me about the plant nutrients? Three important plant nutrients are?
Nitrogen.
Yes. Nitrogen. Phosphorus and potassium. So we call it NPK. Nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. These NPK are the essential plant nutrients, and chemical fertilizers, they provide NPK to the soil. But as you know that by adding these three plant nutrients, NPK, it makes the soil more and more fertile. More and more fertile. So chemical fertilizers have plant nutrients in a concentrated form. इनमें जो plant nutrients fertilizers होते हैं वो किस तरीके से होते हैं? Concentrated form में होते हैं, इसलिए इसको पानी में dissolve करके और कई बार अलग तरीके से इसको use किया जाता है. One thing I would like to ask you, what is better, natural fertilizer, manure or chemical fertilizers?
Natural.
Why, beta?
So because natural is really essential for our environment too.
Okay, Anumega, what is better, natural?
Sir, of course, natural fertilizer is better. Excessive amount of chemical fertilizers, then it will pollute the soil as well as the water.
Okay. Yes, Amay, you would like to say something?
Yes, sir. Natural fertilization is preferred because it causes less pollution, and acid is not too that much.
Okay. So all of you are correct. Manure is better than fertilizers. Manure prepared in the field, fertilizers are prepared in the factory. But fertilizers, excessive use of fertilizers makes the soil pollute. Water also become pollute in nearby areas. If we use excessive fertilizers to the soil, it causes water pollution, it causes soil pollution also. And one thing, suppose somebody is suffering from a disease and doctor prescribed a medicine of 0.5 mg. Okay, beta? And suppose we are giving to that person 50 mg medicine. So next time, definitely in the first time when he or she received 50 mg antibiotic, will get cured. Will get free from problem. But next time when the same problem that person faced, will he or she will get recovered from 0.5 mg? No, body become habitual of 50 mg. So what farmers are doing, they are using excessive fertilizers to the soil. And when excessive fertilizers are using in the soil, we are forcefully growing or increasing the quantity of crop in the field by using excessive fertilizers. So once one bag of chemical fertilizers we use in the field, the next time we have to give more and more quantity of fertilizers to the soil. And continuation, तो बाद में क्या होता है, if repetition every season we are using the crop again and again and we are using excessive fertilizers, so soil become barren after some time. अब उसमें कुछ भी नहीं होगा. So this is very important. So in order to maintain the fertility of the soil, we should use natural fertilizers, that is manure, in place of chemical fertilizers. Is it clear? So there are some differences in between natural and chemical fertilizers, and you can see in your textbook these differences are given. These differences, it is very important to know these differences between manure and chemical fertilizers. You are able to see this?
Sir, it's black.
No, sir, visible.
Yes, sir, now it's visible.
But it is not visible to me. Okay, it's taking time to open. Okay. Yes. Crop production and management, and you can see in your textbook there are differences between manure and fertilizers. Can anybody tell me the first difference between manure and fertilizer?
Yes, sir.
Yes, speak.
Fertilizer is a man-made inorganic salt. Manure is a natural substance obtained by the decomposition of cattle dung and plant reduces.
Okay. It means manure is a natural substance, and that manure is obtained by the decomposition of plant waste, animal waste, and plant residues. And fertilizer is a salt of organic compounds. ये एक सॉल्ट होते हैं. अब ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेरी मच फेमिलियर विद द सॉल्ट, एंड यू आर फेमिलियर विद द ओनली वन सॉल्ट, दैट इज अ कॉमन सॉल्ट और टेबल सॉल्ट दैट वी यूज इन आवर किचन. डू यू नो द केमिकल नेम ऑफ दैट कॉमन सॉल्ट?
नो सर.
यस,
सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड.
यस, नो, इट इज सोडियम क्लोराइड, NaCl. व्हेन यू वर इन क्लास studied about the neutralization reaction of acid and bases, when hydrochloric acid react with sodium hydroxide, it produces sodium chloride. So sodium chloride, it is a salt. Which salt? That we use in our kitchen, common salt, jise hindi mein hum kya kehte hain, namak. Ye wahi namak hai. But in our chemistry, this is not only the salt, there are so many salts, and you will learn these salts in higher classes also. Copper sulfate is one of the salt. Okay, so there are so many salts. So chemical fertilizers are the salt. Second difference between manure and fertilizer, the manure is not very rich in essential plant nutrients. It means nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium are not present in sufficient quantity in the manure. Is it clear, बेटा? आप देखते हैं कि नेचुरल चीज हमारे को फायदा करती है लॉन्ग टर्म यूज में, एंड जो केमिकल चीज होती है ये हमको शॉर्ट टर्म का फायदा देती है, लॉन्ग टर्म लॉस देती है. यस, आप देखते हैं. सो मैनुअर इज लेस रिच इन प्लांट न्यूट्रिएंट्स, बट फर्टिलाइजर्स आर वेरी रिच इन प्लांट न्यूट्रिएंट्स लाइक नाइट्रोजन, फॉस्फोरस एंड potassium. Now third difference, manure provides lot of humus to the soil. अगर हम manure field में use कर रहे हैं तो ये soil को बहुत ज्यादा humus provide करेगा, but chemical fertilizers does not provide any humus to the soil. No support to the soil to increase the quantity of humus. And manure is easily absorbed by the soil, बिकॉज इट इज नॉट मच सॉल्यूबल इन वाटर. जो मैनवर होते हैं उनको सॉइल बहुत जल्दी एब्जॉर्ब कर लेती है, बट केमिकल फर्टिलाइजर्स आर बीइंग सॉल्यूबल इन नेचर. फर्टिलाइजर्स इज रेडिली एब्जॉर्ब बाय द प्लांट्स. ओके, तो मैनवर को स्लोली एब्जॉर्ब करता है, वो पानी में डिजॉल्व नहीं होते हैं. केमिकल फर्टिलाइजर्स पानी में डिजॉल्व करते हैं. ओके, एंड वेरी सिंपल डिफरेंस. यस, मैनवर इज चीप एंड फर्टिलाइजर इज कॉस्टली. Actually, we can, if we are ready to prepare manure in our field, then only it is cheap. When you go to the market and purchase organic vegetables, do you know about the organic food? So it is costly. अगर आप एक टोमेटो 1 kg टोमेटो लाते हैं, ordinary टोमेटो आप जो मार्केट में मिलते हैं, they are not or are the product of using organic manure. वो फर्टिलाइजर से आते हैं, उनका टेस्ट नहीं आता कुछ भी. और अगर आपने अपने किचन गार्डन में एक टोमेटो लगा लिया है, उस एक टोमेटो को आप यूज करेंगे, आप देखेंगे कि उसमें कितना टेस्ट आता है. आज का हम मार्केट से जो टोमेटोज लाते हैं, जो फ्रूट्स लाते हैं, जो ये बहुत ज्यादा ब्राइट होते हैं, कलरफुल होते हैं, बट टेस्ट नहीं होता, न्यूट्रिएंट्स कम होते हैं. तो जो हम प्रोडक्ट इस तरीके से मार्केट में परचेस करते हैं जिसमें ऑर्गेनिक मैनुअर यूज किया गया उस फील्ड में, तो दे आर नॉट चीप, दे आर वेरी कॉस्टली. ओके, सो बट मैनुअर कैन बी प्रिपेयर्ड इन द फील्ड एंड फर्टिलाइजर्स आर प्रिपेयर्ड इन द फैक्ट्रीज. इज इट क्लियर टू ऑल? ऑल दीज डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन मैनुअर एंड फर्टिलाइजर्स. एनी डाउट अबाउट मैनुअर एंड फर्टिलाइजर्स बेटा?
नो सर.
If you have any doubt, you can ask me about the differences and others. So, one more thing, even in the textbook, advantages of manure over fertilizers. So, these are the same points. Manure enhances the water holding capacity of the soil. Very important. What is water holding capacity of the soil? Last year, we discussed about it. Ayan beta, do you know?
No, sir.
Okay. Bhargavi?
Sir, percolation?
No, percolation is different than water hotel, but it is related. You can relate it. Anumega?
Water retention.
Okay. Ame?
Sir.
Yes, Anumega is correct. Anumega is correct. Hena? If we pour a glass of water to the soil, so it easily drain through the soil or it remains in the soil for some time. What is its water retention capacity? कितनी देर तक ये पानी इसमें रहता है, या पानी सीधे चला जाता है नीचे, ऊपर से डाला सीधे नीचे चला गया. अगर आप देखें, if you take a heap of sand, sand is one of the soil. And you pour water over there. So how quickly water drain through the soil particles in the sand? But other type of soil, which soil? Clay soil. It will take time to pass. It means using manure can improve the water holding capacity of the soil. This is very important point. Second point, it makes the soil porous. Porous due to which exchange of gases through the soil particles take place. So this is another advantage of using manure in the field. It improves, makes the soil porous. Soil porous होना चाहिए, तभी तो उसमें से gas exchange possible होगा. Yes? अच्छा, air pass होगी, air उसमें रहेगी, तो जो microorganisms है वो उसमें survive कर सकते हैं. और जब माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म, लॉट ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द ग्रोथ ऑफ द सॉइल, एंड इन दिस वे मैनुअर इंप्रूव्स द यूजफुल माइक्रोब्स इन द सॉइल, एंड इट इंप्रूव द टेक्सचर ऑफ द सॉइल, इट इंप्रूव द केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द सॉइल. सो दीज आर द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ यूजिंग मैनुअर ओवर फर्टिलाइजर्स. लेकिन ये वही है जैसे कोई बीमार पड़ा तो उसके पास दो ऑप्शन है, होम्योपैथी और एलोपैथी. जल्दी ठीक होना है तो क्या लेंगे?
एलोपैथी.
एलोपैथी. और बॉडी को साइड इफेक्ट्स नहीं होना चाहिए, तब कौन सी पैथी का यूज करेंगे?
होम्योपैथी।
होम्योपैथी, लेकिन इमरजेंसी है तो होम्योपैथी या का यूज कर सकते हैं? नहीं, इमरजेंसी में एलोपैथी, किसी का ऑपरेशन करना है, किसी को ऑक्सीजन सप्लाई करना है, तो हम उस समय उसको वी हैव टू इमीडिएटली प्रोवाइड प्रॉपर ट्रीटमेंट, एलोपैथिक ट्रीटमेंट टू दैट पेशेंट। तो यही डिफरेंस बिटवीन मैनुअल एंड फर्टिलाइजेशन। ओके, सो आई थिंक क्रॉप रोटेशन यूजिंग मैनुअल एंड फर्टिलाइजेशन, ट्रांसप्लांटेशन, एवरीथिंग इज क्लियर। नाउ नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज इरिगेशन। इरिगेशन को क्या कहते हैं हिंदी में?
सिंचाई का, पानी डालना,
पौधों में पानी डालना। अच्छा, मैंने अनुमेगा से कहा कि अपने प्लांट में पॉट में पानी डालिए, उसने क्या किया, सी टेक्स ए बकेट फुल ऑफ वाटर एंड इमीडिएटली पोर्ड फुल अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर विद द ग्रेट रेट टू द सॉइल, टू द प्लांट, टू द पॉट। इज इट अ राइट वे?
नो सर।
नो सर।
सो व्हाट इज द राइट वे?
Pour slowly the water.
Very gently.
Slowly.
Very gently.
Yes, yes, yes. And the that pot in which plant is growing, if we pour water with great force, so it will disturb the soil also. The top layer of the soil, it will come out from the pot. So irrigation का मतलब होता है पौधों में पानी देना, इसको कहते हैं सिंचाई करना। And we are not talking about the irrigation of our kitchen garden pot. We are talking irrigation of agriculture field. Okay? So the supply of water to crop plant in the field is called irrigation. Only this much definition, this much is not sufficient. Supply of water at regular interval in sufficient quantity is called the irrigation. Sufficient quantity, regular supply of water to the crop is called irrigation. Agar aapko pyaas lagi hai, if you are feeling thirsty and you want to drink water, how much you have to, you will drink only a glass of water or two glasses of water at the same time. And in 24 hours, you drink about 8 to 10 liters of water. So I am asking, why throughout the day you are drinking water, better to drink all 6 to 8 liters of water in the morning time. So can you drink this much amount of water at the same time? No, not possible. So ek saath apne aaj first day hai aur pure crop ko pani de diya, laba lab upar tak bhar diya usko, aur phir uske baad hum log ghumne chale gaye for a month. So this is not the irrigation. Water to the crops at regular interval in proper quantity, this is called irrigation. अगर हमने एक साथ पानी दे दिया या regular पानी नहीं दिया, in both the condition crop will damage. अच्छा, why irrigation is necessary? क्यों पानी देने की जरूरत क्या है लोकेश? Why irrigation is necessary for the plant, for the crop?
Sir, because it provide moisture.
Okay, locate
and minerals to the plant.
अच्छा, पानी में minerals होते हैं, फिर fertilizers लगाने की जरूरत ही क्या है? Why irrigation?
Sir, for absorption of nutrients.
Okay, Vyom.
Sir, because plant's body is 90% in water and they need water for other processes like photosynthesis and transpiration.
Sir,
I'm
Ajay,
one more thing I
would say. Sir, may
okay,
I?
Okay, okay. Yes, Sarakshi.
Sir, for germination of seeds.
Okay, okay. You are, all of you are. Acha, what is the right time for irrigation? Before plowing the crop, plowing the seed, plowing the field, or after?
Sir, before.
So best time for irrigation before plowing the field makes the soil soft. अच्छा, आपके घर में कभी कभी पिक्ची बनते हैं, चने बनते हैं, छोले बनते हैं, तो आपकी मदर क्या करती है? She soak these seeds in water throughout the night. देन पुट इन द कुकर प्रेशर कुकर यस कि डायरेक्ट प्रेशर कुकर में डाल देती है सोक करती है
yes,
सोक नहीं करती है अरे सौम्या करती है कि नहीं
करती है, करती है।
अच्छा अगर सौम्या को खाने पीने से मतलब है कैसे बनता है ऐसे कोई मतलब नहीं है है ना सौम्या
नमस्कार करती है
सो वी हैव वेरी गुड वेरी गुड बेटा सो बिफोर प्लाउइंग द सीड्स सॉरी सॉइल को प्लाउइंग करने से पहले उसमें हम इरिगेट करें वाटर डालें तो उससे जो सॉइल है वो सॉफ्ट हो जाती है और उससे क्या होगा जो प्लाउइंग की मेथड है प्लाउइंग की जो प्रोसेस है टर्निंग एंड लूजनिंग द सॉइल के मेथड है तो ये प्रोसेस है वो क्या हो जाएगी थोड़ा सा इजी हो जाती है सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड एज साराक्षी एंड सौम्या टोल्ड दैट कि इरिगेशन इज नेसेसरी टू प्रोवाइड मॉइस्चर फॉर द जर्मिनेशन ऑफ सीड्स एंड इट इज नेसेसरी टू मेंटेन द प्रॉपर मॉइस्चर इन द सॉइल फॉर हेल्दी क्रॉप ग्रोथ एंड इट इज नेसेसरी फॉर एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट्स एंड वाटर सप्लाई टू क्रॉप ड्यूरिंग इरिगेशन प्रोटेक्ट द क्रॉप प्लांट फ्रॉम हॉट एयर करेंट्स ऑल ऑफ यू नो दैट ड्यूरिंग द टाइम ऑफ समर वी नीड टू ड्रिंक मोर वाटर यस And if the same thing happened with the plants, if we do not provide water to our plants, so they become dry after some time. So every day, morning time, evening time, we provide water. And one thing I would like to ask, what is the right time to give water to plants? Morning, evening or afternoon?
Sir, morning.
Morning.
Sir, your voice is not coming clear.
Morning or evening?
Morning and evening, sir. Both the times.
Yes, morning and evening, but not the afternoon time. So during the time of afternoon, the temperature is very high. And when we start irrigating the plant, most of the water will evaporate. Do you know about the evaporation? Conversion of water into its vapor is called the evaporation. So this is very important. Acha, is irrigation depends on the nature of the crop?
Yes, sir.
Definitely. Very good. These are the factors. Factors affect the irrigation requirement of crops. Aapke ghar mein chota bhai ya choti behan hai, and he or she is studying in class 1 and you are in class 8. The requirement of drinking water is same for both the child, different. That 1 year old, 6 year old need lesser amount of water in comparison to us. Yes. So nature of the crop providing irrigation or that affect the irrigation requirement of the soil. Kis prakar ka nature hai? Aapko sabhi ko malum hai. Rice or dhan. पैडी दे नीड स्टैंडिंग सपोर्ट ऑफ वाटर आपने कभी देखा होगा कि जो राइस है वो उसके जो प्लांट्स रहते हैं छोटे छोटे वो पूरे पानी में डूबे रहते हैं देखा है आपने स्टैंडिंग सपोर्ट ऑफ वाटर ओके सो नेचर ऑफ द क्रॉप इट क्वांटिटी ऑफ इरिगेशन क्वांटिटी ऑफ वाटर प्रोवाइडिंग टू द क्रॉप इज डिपेंड्स ऑन द नेचर ऑफ द क्रॉप एंड सेकेंड इज नेचर ऑफ द सॉइल कौन सी सॉइल है कोई सॉइल कम पानी एब्जॉर्ब करेगी कोई ज्यादा एब्जॉर्ब करेगी किसी का वाटर होल्डिंग कैपेसिटी कम होगा किसी का ज्यादा होगा किसी का परकुलेशन रेट ज्यादा होगा किसी का परकुलेशन रेट कम होगा सो इट डिपेंड्स एंड वन मोर फैक्टर ऑन विच द अमाउंट ऑफ इरीगेशन डिपेंड्स दैट इज सीजन Yes. In rainy season, how many times you water your kitchen garden? Already water is there. Hai na? So there are three factors which affect the irrigation requirement of the crop. Number one, nature of the crop, nature of the soil, and season. These three are very important factors that affect the irrigation to the crop. Okay? The crop grown in a sandy soil need irrigation more frequently. ऐसी soil जैसे sandy soil में कोई crop हो रही है तो उसको ज्यादा पानी की जरूरत होगी because it drains water quickly in comparison to clay soil. Okay, so this is very important. Now, do you know about the types of irrigation? There are two techniques. One technique is modern means of irrigation and another one is traditional method of irrigation. आपकी बुक में देखिए ट्रेडिशनल मेथड ऑफ इरिगेशन बहुत सारी दिखी है, पुली सिस्टम, चेन पंप, ढेकली, रहट, लीवर सिस्टम, दीज आर द ट्रेडिशनल मेथड ऑफ इरिगेशन, बट देयर आर टू मॉडर्न मीन्स ऑफ इरिगेशन एंड दीज टू आर ड्रिप इरिगेशन सिस्टम एंड स्प्रिंकलर सिस्टम. विच इज बेटर, ट्रेडिशनल और मॉडर्न?
मॉडर्न.
मॉडर्न.
Why modern?
Because it conserves water.
Our time and also don't waste water.
Yes, very good. Modern techniques of irrigation, it reduces the loss of water and it saves the time also. Okay, so this is the difference in between these two. I am not going in traditional method of irrigation. You can read by yourself. I will explain you sprinkler system. Just see the picture of sprinkler system. What happens in the sprinkler system? Have you seen?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
It sprinkles water. Already...
Again, disturbance in voice. Yes, beta. Sprinkler system. What is the sprinkler system?
It sprinkles water on the plants.
So what happens? There is a main pipe, yes, and there are perpendicular pipes. You can see the picture in the text. There is a main pipe. There are some perpendicular pipes at the same distance, and these perpendicular pipes having a nozzle at the top. And when water passes through the main pipe, then vertical pipes, then nozzle start rotating. इस प्रकार से घूमता है नोजल एंड इट कवर्स अ वाइड एरिया. इट कवर्स अ वाइड एरिया. सो आपने देखा होगा बेटा कि जहां भी स्प्रिंकलर सिस्टम यूज हो रहा है वहां कहीं पर ऐसा वाटर लॉगिंग नहीं होता कि बहुत सारा पानी एक सा एक जगह जमा हो, क्योंकि लेसर अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर स्प्रेड इन अ इंटरवल ऑफ टाइम बिकॉज नोजल रोटेट. So water is not reaching at the same point continuously. When one round completed, then again reach there, then again reach there. So there is a regular time. Soil also gets suitable time to absorb water that reaches to it. जो पानी जहां गिर रहा है वहां से उस पानी को जमीन में अंदर जाने के लिए कुछ टाइम जरूरी है. So this is sprinkler system. Sprinkler system, it is very useful for sandy soil also. Okay, जहां uneven land है वहां पर भी हम इसका use कर सकते हैं. And another one is drip irrigation. As all of you know about the drip, when you go to hospital and sometimes have you seen some patients, they get a medicine through the drip. So drip means, what does it mean? Drop by drop supply is called the drip. And in the drip irrigation, water drop by drop supplied directly to the plant's root. Pani kisko chahiye? Roots ko chahiye. Yes. And so drip by drip water reaches to plant root. So in this way, plant root absorb water. It provides water to plant drop by drop and no wastage of water at all. And it minimizes the use of water in agriculture. So it is very useful in such regions where the availability of water is less. Kya Hindustan mein sab jagah sufficient water hai for the irrigation? No.
No, sir.
So in such areas, in some areas where there is no sufficient amount of water available for irrigation, this drip irrigation system, sprinkler system, are very useful. So I hope, acha, irrigation is okay. What happened? Now some one question. if we provide excessive amount of water to the soil, what will happen? Will it damage the crop?
Yes, sir.
So the both the conditions, providing lesser amount of water and excessive amount of water, in both the cases, this water damage the soil, damage the crop, damage the seeds, will not get sufficient time and space for germination. So excessive irrigation is not good for the crop. Not excessive supply of water, not lesser amount of water supply to plant are necessary. So dear students, I hope you understood manure and fertilizers and irrigation. Yes, Lokesh.
सर बहुत पहले मेरे पापा ने एक पौधा लगाया था, एक बॉटल में उसमें सिर्फ पानी डाला था, मिट्टी नहीं डाली थी, तो वो थोड़ा थोड़ा उग रहा था बहुत दिनों में। सर वो तो ग्रो कैसे कर गया सिर्फ पानी में?
आप अगर देखें तो मनी प्लांट ऐसा होता है जो पानी में ग्रो कर जाता है, उसको सॉइल की जरूरत नहीं होती। दूसरा चीज, आपके यहाँ मिंट आता है घर में, अभी समर चल रहा है तो मिंट आता होगा, जिसको हम पुदीना कहते हैं। आप उस पुदीने की जो लीव्स हैं वो निकाल लीजिए और जो उसका स्टेम बचता है उसको एक गिलास में डाल दीजिए जिसमें पानी भरा हो। आप कुछ दिन में देखेंगे, 3-4 दिन में उसमें से रूट्स निकल के आ जाएंगे और वो फिर आप जमीन पे लगा दीजिए। तो बेटे, कुछ प्लांट्स को बहुत ज्यादा प्लांट सप्लीमेंट की जरूरत नहीं होती, वो सिर्फ पानी से ही ग्रो कर जाते हैं, लेकिन ये बहुत लिमिटेड होते हैं, सभी नहीं होते। आप मनी प्लांट की बात कर रहे हैं, कुछ और ऐसे ही क्रीपर्स क्लाइंबर्स होते हैं, वो भी बिना सॉइल के सपोर्ट के ग्रो कर जाते हैं।
यस सर, आई होप। सर मेरे पापा ने मनी प्लांट लगाया था, फिर वो थोड़ा उग गया था, फिर उसको वो गमले में लगा दिया था।
यस। सो आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड व्हाटएवर आई ट्राइड टू एक्सप्लेन यू। रिमेनिंग थिंग्स वी विल डिस्कस नेक्स्ट वीक। नाउ शांति पाठ। शांति शांति शांति। साई राम चिल्ड्रन।
साई राम सर।